Hi friends, I am Funny. Today I come up with the topic safe lifting. The lifting of materials generally occurs on construction areas or sites. Correct lifting can move large objects efficiently and reduce manual handling operations. Incorrect lifting procedures cause injuries, loss of work time and property. Follow and implement required safety measures to reduce lifting accidents. Contents in this topic are people, roles and responsibilities of persons involved in lifting activity, cranes, types of cranes, maintenance and inspection, lifting gears, types of lifting gears, its maintenance and inspection, hazards, dangers associated in lifting activity, and do's and don'ts, safe lifting procedure. Personnel related to the lifting operation include competent person, crane operator, slinger, signaler, and others working nearby. The roles and responsibilities of personnel related to the lifting operation include, for competent persons, properly trained with relevant practical experience and responsible for regular examination of lifting gears. For crane operator, he shall be physically fit and hold a valid crane operation certificate. And he is responsible for operating crane correctly and safely. Then slinger. He is responsible for attaching and detaching load to and from the crane and capable of selecting lifting gears suitable for the load. And signaler. He is responsible for relaying the signals from the slinger to the crane operator. And he shall be able to direct the movement of crane and loads. Maintenance and inspection of cranes. Mobile cranes, the mobile crane shall only be operated on a firm level ground that adequately supports the weight of the crane and loads. Before lifting, fully extend the outriggers and ensure their stability on the ground. The weight of the load shall not exceed the safe working load. Never abruptly swing or stop the crane. Load shall not be dragged on the ground. Adjust the boom length to ensure the crane is operating within the extent of safe operation radius. And when moving uphill or downhill, the boom angle shall be adjusted to the safe working condition. Tower cranes. All cranes shall have regular maintenance to ensure they always kept in good operating conditions. Ensure that the automatic safe load indicator is installed. Provide safe means of access and egress. Ensure that the lifting roots do not collide with any objects. Lifting roots shall not come across any building or pass over any person. Travel speed shall be as slow as possible to ensure the load stability. Be aware of the height of the lifting, the length of the crane's trolley, and refer to the load chart. Now we see lifting gears, its inspection, and do's and don'ts while using lifting gears. The types of lifting gears are wire rope slings, chain slings, shackles, eye bolts, hooks, rings, links, and swivels. Wire rope slings. Use only suitable wire rope slings. Never use damaged wire rope slings. The wire rope slings shall not be used and shall be disposed if they are broken wires, bird cages, kinks, surface wires are worn, and change of diameter of the wire rope sling. During lifting, the safe working load must not be exceeded. Regular inspection shall be conducted. Sudden elevation is not allowed. If more than one wire rope sling is used in lifting, pay attention to the angle between the slings. The cable clip shall be properly installed according to the following points. There is a minimum of 3 cable clips. The direction of installation shall be correct. The distance between the cable clips shall be the same. Chain slings. The chain slings shall not be used under the following conditions. No ordinary chains shall be used for lifting. The safe working load shall not be exceeded. No knots or bolts that shorten the chain length shall be used. Chain slings have no flexibility, so striking objects must be avoided while lifting. Regular inspection shall be conducted, and do not use hammers to reshape a deformed chain sling. Shackles. Never replace the shackle pin with a bolt. Ensure the pin is totally locked. Do not use screw pin shackle if the pin can roll and unscrew. During lifting, shackle shall not lean to one side. Check that shackle is not opening up. Shackle pin must always be attached to the hook. Eye bolts. The hook shall not be directly fixed onto the eye bolt. Plain eye bolts only apply to the vertical lifting. The angle of the lifting of shoulder eye bolts shall not be less than 45 degrees. Watchers may use it to ensure that the shoulder is firmly in contact with the surface. Never use a sling through a pair of eye bolts. Hooks. All hooks shall be installed with safety latches. Hooks can be installed with swivels to allow the load to revolve. Select hook of the right size. Do not tie or remove the safety latches. Maintain the hook in a vertical position. If the hook is eccentrically loaded, the safe working load will be reduced. Ring slings and swivels. Most of the ring slings and swivels are marked with safe working load. If no safe working load is marked, the safe working load table shall be checked according to the diameters. Spreader beams. Spreader beams are commonly used for lifting long loads. The weight of the spreader beam shall be included as a part of lifting load. Each of the contacted points shall not exceed the safe working load. The main hazards in lifting activity are overturning of the crane, breaking boom sling, touching overhead power lines, and falling objects. Safe lifting procedure include three main parts. First one is safe working load. Second one is safe operating procedure. And third one is crane hand signals. What is a safe working load and what are the checkpoints to be considered while lifting? First one is, what is a safe working load? It is the maximum safe force that a piece of lifting equipment, lifting device or accessory can exert to lift, suspend or lower the given mass without fear of breaking. And the checkpoints are: know the weight and shape of the load. Loose load shall be packed or placed in suitable containers before lifting. The containers must be structurally sound and four slings must be used to avoid inclining. The container shall be examined and marked with safe working load. Pay attention to the load's center gravity. Ensure that it is kept directly under main hook. Corner pad shall be used for loads with sharp edges. When lifting large or heavy loads, wind and operator visibility must be considered. Safe lifting procedure. Plan a suitable lifting route to avoid collision with any persons, objects, or overhead power lines. Do not drag loads. Move the loads as near to the ground level as possible. Stop people from standing in the lifting area. Do not ride on a load that is being lifted. When the crane is in operation, it must maintain a distance of 600 meters square from any buildings. When on a slope, adjust the outriggers to keep the crane horizontal. If there are excavations near the lifting appliances, strengthen the excavation support. Crane hand signals. When there is a lot of traffic at a work site, it is essential for workers to be able to use hand signals. Here are some standard hand signals for crane operation. Emergency stop and stop. Ready to move and move slowly. Move away from the signal man. Move towards from the signal man. Move towards the hand structure direction. Extend the boom. Lower the hoist. Raise the hoist. Lower the boom and raise the load. Raise the boom and lower the load. Use the main hoist and use whip line. Lower the boom and raise the load. Swing towards the hand stretcher direction. Lower the load slowly and stop everything. I would like to quickly summarize the main points are proper maintenance and inspection of cranes, follow safety instructions, and follow hand crane signals while operating. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel for more updates.